bet he's over there. We'll just kind of tilt the room. You could have heard me, but anyway, I want to welcome everybody here, even if we are a little bit on that side. Anyway, that's okay. So welcome to Christmas Eve at Bethel. We love seeing this whole clan here. I'm so thrilled to see you. You filled up the whole side of the church. That's terrific. And to see everybody else here, a few faces we haven't seen in a while, so that's wonderful. And I just hope you have a lovely time. I think everybody knows where the restrooms are, but just in case, there's a men's room downstairs out there, a ladies' powder room over there, and an accessible restroom at the end of the hall to the right through the glass door. That's it. There's a water fountain out there, but when I went out there, it wasn't giving me any water. So if it still doesn't give you any water, just go to the kitchen and get a cup and some water. So that's about it. And I'm going to invite Joshua to lead us in the call to worship.
Everyone, please stand and join us in the call to worship. Rejoice, for God is with us, Emmanuel.
In the darkness of our world shines God's holy light.
Now there is a reason to hope, to love, to laugh, and to live.
God is truly with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God.
Please join in our opening hymn. O come, all ye faithful. should be on your screen and in the hymnals. And in your handouts.
Yeah, it's on the screen, and there were some sheets of words in the back, because the hymnal has some odd words here and there. So we decided to go ahead and use traditional words which are on the screen. So off we go.
Gracious God, with joy and thanksgiving, we gather as your people. We have come to hear again the timeless story of Christ's birth. In the excitement of this night, quiet our hearts, that we may know the peace and fullness of this holy time. Shine, O light, in the darkness of our world. Sing, O angels, in the stillness of our hearts. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those God favors. This we pray in the name of the Child of Bethlehem. Amen.
Thank you. people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Our joy tonight began with the birth of Emmanuel, which means God is with us.
In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored, the Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel. "Since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be barren is in her sixth month, for nothing is impossible with God." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May it be to me as you have said." In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken from the entire Roman world. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child. While they were there, the first time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to his firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you.
sing a little Town of Bethlehem together, a little bit more traditionally. That, as you could tell, was sort of a stylized with special solos and other songs in between. So now you get to sing this. So let's stand together and sing a little Town of Bethlehem.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flock at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Thank you. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men in whom his favor rests."
Stand up and stretch and sing another carol together.
Oh.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea. During the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." Then the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was.
This is really
When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child was with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold and of incense and of myrrh.
Two trays that we use for offerings. One is just for a regular offering, and the other one is if you have some little spare change or something like that that you'd like to throw in, please do. That is our children's offering, and it goes for our pet food bank and for our Fifth Friday dinners. the title now? Where did that go? I know it's your son. You know, we have this thing that we have the Christmas story. And I'm going to do something a little bit weird. I'm going to pretend to be a couple of people having a conversation about this story. So, here's the first person. One December night, over 2,000 years ago, a shining star illuminated a gathering of kings, angels, shepherds, and animals round a baby in a stable. It was a nativity, and it marked the end of a journey that began on a donkey's back. Whoa, hold up there. That's the other person, in case you didn't hear that. I beg your pardon. Your nativity, that's not exactly how it happened. Look, let's start with the donkey. Neither of the gospel stories mentions Mary traveling by donkey. And given the 60 miles of rough terrain that they traveled, it's more likely that they traveled with a wagon. Well, that's just minor details. But then the innkeeper informs them that there's no room in the inn. Again, the Bible doesn't really mention an innkeeper. And in Greek, the word inn refers to an upper room in a house, not really a motel. Oh, blast. Well, wherever it was, there was no room, so Mary and Joseph were sent to the stable. No stable. That's not in the Bible either. Well, now you're catching on. In those days, most animals were kept in a cave. A cave? Really? Yep. Could have been a cave instead of a stable, but the Bible doesn't really say. And the star of Bethlehem? Duh, that's biblical. Well, we're actually right for once. It's a Christmas miracle. Okay. So then we have the shepherds coming and the three kings. No kings. Three kings is from the song. The Bible says magi, which are wise men. Three wise men? Well, that works. Well, not so fast. The Bible does mention three gifts, but it doesn't specify the number of wise men that brought them. You mean there could have been more? Yeah, there could have been a whole posse of wise men. Well, it's a miracle with that crowd that baby Jesus never cried. What, you mean no crying he makes? Well, that's just a lyric from Away in a Manger, not an actual scripture. Well, of course he was crying. It just added a whole crowd of people. A bunch of strange people. Shepherds and wise men. Well, actually, the wise men weren't there yet. You see, never mind. That's enough. You have just dismantled everything that makes this most inspiring image of Christian tradition. It's gone. So what's your point? Point? Well, I guess it's this. Even when all of the man-made traditions are stripped away, the eternal truths remain. Whether they traveled by donkey or by wagon, God brought them safely to the birthplace that was prophesied. Whether born in a stable or in a cave, God provided shelter in a new land. Whether there were three kings, three wise men, or many wise men, whether there was a crowd or just a few, God called the elect to bear witness in testimony to the birth of Emmanuel. So, whether your manger looks like this, or like this, the one thing that remains unchanged is this: the baby boy, born of a virgin this day in the city of David, a savior, which is Christ the Lord. Well, bless you, I will never look at December 25th. Now, some of you know, getting away from the cute little script, some of you know that, of course, it might not have been December 25th. A lot of people think it might have been in the springtime. But the points are the same. Those eternal truths, the reasons that we're even here, the reasons that we're here tonight, the whole heart of why we're here, is to welcome that light into the world, to welcome that joy and that peace, and to give that same safe spot in our hearts. It's exhausting right now, and it's challenging, and it's hard. It's hard to have a smile on your face when things are tough. It's hard to have a smile on your face when you're feeling pain. And sometimes it's easy to have a smile on your face when someone brings you the right cup of coffee or cookies. I like coffee and cookies. The point is, share that joy and that light in some kind of real and tangible way. Help somebody, support your family, say thank you, things like that, little things. I'm much happier when someone says thank you or helps me pick something up. The other day, I got home from Stater Brothers and I was carrying in the bags, and out of like 10 bags, 5 of them split on the bottom while I was trying to take the stuff into the house, you know, in milk cartons and everything. And I was standing outside the parsonage. Of course, the whole neighborhood knows it's a parsonage, and I was just like, okay, it's fine, it's fine. No eggs broke. But it was frustrating. You know, and that was minor. At least I had the money to go and buy the milk and the butter and the eggs and bread. So it's time to be thankful. It's time to thank God for the gifts that God has given us. And it's time, really, to take that joy and that light and celebrate it. So now, we're going to sing Joy to the World. I'm going to let Sandy get up there. Okay, so we're going to stand together and sing Joy to the World, and then we're going to come to some other parts of our service.
Your presence transforms our lives. Sisters and brothers, before we go forth from this peaceful place, let us take a good look around us at one another.
See what beauty is revealed among us.
coming now to this part of our service where we light our candles. Now, we don't have a dimmer, so you're just going to light candles and enjoy the candles. And I might send someone out. Joshua, do you know which switch it is?
Or which one?
Maybe the...
Just the back.
Yeah, right there. Anyway, I'll send him out in a little bit after we've gotten some candles lit.
Give me a nice, big, get out of here.
Chunk, yeah. Anyway, so what we're going to do is we're going to start with the light from the Christ candle. I'm going to ask somebody in the front row to come on up and get their flame, so I guess I can invite Stacy to come up and do that. And what happens with this is we just begin with that candle, and she's going to light that and take it back. And then she holds her candle up, and the next person holds their unlit candle to it like this. And we go around the room that way. And when we get about over here, we send one over across. And I'm going to ask the choir to go ahead and stand so they can sing Peace, Peace with us while we do this. After they've sung a couple times through the words Peace, Peace, I'm going to invite you to join us with Silent Night. Of course, Joshua will sneak out. Somewhere near that. Wait a little while.
Thank you.